Hi friends and welcome to my channel. So today I'm going to do monthly predictions for three zodiac signs. I know you guys want monthly predictions and I said that it is a little difficult for me to pull out every monthly prediction in like one video at a time and such you know videos of 20, 24 minute, 25 minute videos. And that's why this month, because first week of the month is already gone, I was not thinking to make these videos, but I'm getting so many requests. People want to know about their zodiac sign and what this month is bringing, and because this month is a lot of about push and pull and a lot of things are happening, so what I'm going to do is I'm going to compile multiple readings, like three readings in one go. The readings are not going to be very extensive, but I will try to cover every aspect of the reading in your reading. And I already have done the Aquarius, Piscean, Aries and Taurus. These four signs are already done. The videos are already on the channel. And today I'm going to talk about Gemini, Cancer and Leo. These three I'm going to cover into this video. So I hope this video helps you and you get to know what you really want to know or what is really needed for you. So let's just start with Gemini. Gemini, this is the month where you need to take action, where you need to move forward, where you need to take responsibility, where you need to make choices, but at the same time be very poised within yourself. At the same time be very careful and cautious and in your power, in your energy. So know where you're moving and know how you are moving forward, but you need to keep moving forward. In terms of your career, I feel that you will have choices. And this is the time where you will make some steps forward in your career. So it can be a new job, it can be a new opportunity, or it can be traveling for your old job or doing something which is a little step forward from your old job. Traveling, I'm a little dicey at this point in time because of lockdowns and everything, but still there is travel that is happening essentially if it is needed, and that kind of travel you might have to do. If you need to travel, ensure that you're taking all the precautions that are needed. That's going to be very important. Second, for your relationships, I would say that this is the month where don't push anything on anyone. The relationships will go better. There are things that will happen in relationship. They will be nurtured. You can take steps if you want to go into relationship with somebody or you want to take your relationship further with somebody. All those things are possible, but ensure that you're not becoming too pushy. Give other person the choice and then move forward. And if you actually be a little more open, your relationships are going to get better. For money situation, I feel things will be balanced. There is nothing that you should really be worried about. There are things where you will make progress. Now I'm going to read these cards, and the wisdom oracle card, I'm going to talk about your relationship, I'm going to talk about your generic soul message, and I'm going to talk about your career and money situation also. So all three will be covered in this, and then we'll talk about your soul path. So the message for you is choices. It says, when you accept responsibility for your life and the choices you make, you begin to tap into the power of your own spirit. You will be able to listen to and appreciate the intuitive wisdom that's inside you and apply it positively and constructively to your outside world. And that's what I'm saying, that this month, if you take authority, if you take the charge of situation, if you be responsible and make the wise choices, you're going to move forward. If we talk about the card Poised, which is number 48 card, there you go. Okay, so this card basically says that the generic message that this card has, or the soul message that this card has, says you can be assured that you're ready for anything right now. You know what you need to. Your skills are sharp. You have come to this place armed with wisdom and knowledge, and you sense a new phase in your life about to begin. People respond to your confidence and trust you. This is an auspicious time for new beginnings, and that is why there is Knight of Wands, which is saying take steps, move forward, make choices and get to new beginnings. The relationship message for you is, when you are confident and happy in your own skin, you are ready for a deeper, more intimate relationships. You have nothing to prove right now. You are completely yourself and can handle anything. Love, friendships and harmonious new connections all are present now and are coming in. You're ready to give and receive from the heart. This is a beautiful place to be. So yes, absolutely, I see that as well, that you can move forward and relationships are going to become better. Prosperity message has your career and money situation. This says you have every reason to feel confident. Everything you need to make your success concrete is now at your disposal. You can take action knowing you are ready to step into your power, into your light, and into your service to the world. The direction you are moving in is your destiny. Your soul is smiling with joy as you align with this truth. So that is why this month, if you have any interview, anything, be poised. Be into your energy, be into your confidence, and everything will kind of crack out. Everything will become better. You will get anything that you want. For your soul message, I would say you need to take responsibility and appreciate yourself and be positive. If you do that, you're going to see positive changes in your life. So that's about Gemini. Let's go to Cancerians. For Cancerians, this is the month where you need to understand that if you are feeling vulnerable, you don't have to run away from any situation. Second, you cannot safeguard everyone from everything. So right now, because of COVID situation, you might be feeling emotionally pulled down. You might be feeling that you have to save everybody from everything. You have to save your loved ones. But one thing that Seven of Swords says, that no matter how much you try, you cannot do everything for everyone. At the same time, everyone has their lessons, and you have to learn that. You have to understand that if there are some people who are trying to do things behind your back, you should not get impacted with them. You should not become negative about that. And also, at the same time, don't run away from the situations. Don't make a decision where you want to kind of do something that you shouldn't be doing. So you need to be very, very careful. You need to be very, very into your energy, thinking about the blessings that you have in your life and not becoming negative at all. If I talk about your relationships, again, the cards are saying that it is very important to be there with people, to support them, but at the same time, neither run away nor overdo it. So bring in that balance. This is not the month for major outside relationships. This is the month for your relationship within yourself, with yourself. So your soul and your body, that kind of a relationship. If you talk about your career, I would say this month, don't leave the job. Whatever job you have, continue with that. In case there is a situation where you have to leave your job, or where because of some situations, you are kind of asked to leave your job, count your blessings. Know that there is something better that is coming your way. Don't get negative at all. This month is not about negativity. This month is not about being negative. For money situation, again, there is a card of blessings. So I will say that however vulnerable you feel there are problems, they are going to be blessings, and you will be blessed with everything that you need. The card that I have for you is vulnerability. It says it is confirmation that you are seeking to tread into the unknown, unfamiliar territory, where decisions are based more on intuition than rationality. Don't let fear hold you back, or allow a misguided sense that feeling vulnerable is somehow a negative condition. So don't let yourself be fearful, or don't think that being vulnerable is a negative condition. Yes, we all are vulnerable right now. Everyone is facing certain or the other kind of issue because of COVID, because of losing loved ones. But that vulnerability is only negative when you feel negative about it. When you focus on the blessings, and trust me, whatever is happening for a good reason, and we'll know the reason very, very soon. But please count your blessings this month. It is very important for you to completely be focused on the blessings. And we will read this card, and this card will tell you about your career, your generic message, like your soul and your relationships. So this card says, there are moments in life when out of the blue, it seems that everything has been orchestrated by divine intervention. And yes, this is orchestrated. So this is definitely divine intervention that is happening. You feel blessed in ways that are difficult to express. It is as if the Red Sea parts in front of you and events come together to banish your troubles easily and naturally. You know deep down you did not deserve any of it, and yet here you are. This is one of those times. Let awe and gratitude for all your blessings guide you now. The more, like I said, the more you do thank you exercise, the more you count your blessings, the more you become positive, the better this situation is going to be for you. Relationship wise, the card is saying you're moving towards a deepening of intimacy in a unique and sacred partnership. You know you are meant to make this connection. This union blessed by the divine will bring transformation and beauty to the world. This is also a sign that, even more important, you are being called to a deeper intimacy with yourself and spirit. With this new development, you will see evidence of grace in your life. So basically, like I said, it is between you, yourself, your soul, your body and your guides or your spirit. So that is why you need to count more blessings and you need to focus on meditations this month. Prosperity message. This is your career and money situation. It says unexpected windfalls and good fortune come your way now. You are at a phase where any difficulties or obstacles they have stymied your success seem to be disappear on their own. Be ready to receive. The windows of opportunity will now open wide. Accept the blessings given to you now. Don't forget to share them. So like I said, that this is the month where you don't have to run away. Don't feel negative. Don't feel worried, because there are a lot of blessings that will come your way. You just have to count your blessings. And for your soul lesson or soul growth also, counting your blessings and practicing thank you exercise is going to help you beautifully well. So do that this month. Now let's move to Leo. Now two cards kind of jumped out for Leo and I kept both of them. And in general, the Leo reading is about where is your focus? What do you want to focus at? What do you want to look at? This month, be very careful. Where are you putting your attention into? And if you can, put your attention into learning something better, learning something new, or relaxing. Relaxation is going to be very important. Giving yourself some time is going to be very important. If you talk about relationships, you will have to understand whatever relationships are in your life, they are there. They are meant to be there. Some people will come, some people will go, but they are all for your learnings. And you have to understand that the best relationship that you share is with your own self, and then you have all the support. You will not be alone, but you have to understand your relationship with yourself. If you talk about the money and career, I feel there could be certain kind of new learning or growth or some money flow into your life, or there could be that money is your focus in this month. But don't be worried, because things will flow into a way that they should. And if you've had or faced any kind of money loss in the previous months, you're going to make good for that. So you don't have to be worried about that. Now the first card that I have for you says support. It says people come into your life for many different reasons. Some you learn from and then they move on, while others return often because you need to learn more from those individuals. Others remain beside you throughout your entire life, and that is why each one, every role is important. If somebody is leaving your life, understand that that person's role is done in your life. If there is somebody who is coming back into your life, understand that there is still some more learning that you have associated with that person. And then the people who are going to be there are going to be there always. Second card is you are not alone. We are here with you. We never left. Through all the sadness and loneliness, however, you cannot sense us near you or feel how much love we are sending you. We are your family, friends and guides. You never walk alone. We walk right beside you. So that's why you don't have to feel lonely. You don't have to feel alone. You have to know that there are people, there are souls in the disguise of friends, family, guides, but they're always around you. The energies are always around you, and you have to understand that and appreciate that. The oracle message, the wisdom oracle card, I'm going to talk about the basic message, the generic message, which is your soul message as well, then your relationship message, and then your prosperity, which is your career and your money situation. So this says oracle message. This is a time to step away and rest. Let the cares of your world go. Go into the state of non-action and allow yourself to be free from the shackles of your goals, your lists and your desires. Nothing is important as rest, detachment and neutrality. The overly busy mind can block you from inner wisdom if you don't step back, take a seat and rest. Be willing to let dreams surface and ideas flow through you, absent any force or conscious direction, as you observe without engagement now. So for a while, just let yourself relax, because the more the thoughts are, the less the ideas are, the less the positivity is. So you'll have to relax yourself and let the engagement go for a while. Just observe your thoughts. If you talk about your relationship message, it says, when it comes to a matter of heart, don't make any plans right now. If you are not partnered, it's good to take this time to get to know yourself. If you are involved with someone, relax and just be with your partner. This is going to be an uneventful moment in time. Don't force anything now. Allow things to flow naturally, and a beautiful renewal will take place by itself. Patience is the key to your heart's desire right now. Withdraw from action in your relationship and give it a rest so that the love and connection can become rejuvenated. And this is essentially required. If you love somebody, if you are with somebody, you will have to relax, have patience, let go of that person, let that person come back, and don't act, don't ask, don't say, don't do anything. Rather, maybe make your connection with yourself a little more stronger. The prosperity message, which is your money and career, this says, this is a great time to take a break from your busy schedule and allow yourself an opportunity to step back. Your plans are meant to be put on ice. Your goals can wait. Dream, imagine, and let go of attachments to any outcome now. Meditate and take a holiday if you can. Things will speed up soon enough. After a break, you may want to make some changes. Epiphanies have an amazing way of arising when you take your focus off your to-do list and allow yourself to rest. So that's the message, that you need to allow yourself to rest, take some break, relax, give your mind some rest, and let things flow. Your soul message is also to understand that you're not alone and you need time to rest. So meditations are going to be important for you. So these are the three zodiacs that I cover in this video, and the next video I'm going to cover the rest of the no actually not rest of all of the zodiacs, but next three, and then the rest. So I hope these videos help you. I'm doing my bit to whatever I can to get you some information or some things to make you keep you going and positive. And next month also probably I'll do readings like this, because next month readings are to be done in this month, and this month is little pull and push for me, so I'll probably do the readings like this only. And from July probably we'll get back to our routine. So thank you so much, and if you want your personalized reading, then you can contact me through the Facebook link that's in the description box or through the comment section. Thank you so much, all the best, bye bye.